As any seasoned pro will admit, building an SEO-friendly site is not easy. It's okay to admit that. Let's do it here and let's move on. They might follow SEO best practices, including fast load times, mobile-friendly experience, and descriptive URLs. However, coming up with a solid plan and a structured approach representing the services you offer your customers, y'all, it can be daunting.
Don't worry, this is a safe space. But our first item on the checklist is have a responsive web design. Mobile users are more likely to leave a site if it is not responsive. When users spend less time on a page, it will lead to a higher bounce rate. And on the other hand, when users spend more time on a website, it's good for SEO. Google's mobile-friendly tests will help check whether your mobile site is optimized for mobile devices. Also, WordPress and many other platforms allow you to view your site on different devices too.
That's right, Neely. I've shared that Google's mobile-friendly test on some of the webinars I've done, and people have been jazzed to use it. Super convenient. Moving on, let's talk about how to make navigation search engine friendly. Navigation is another vital element of web design. And you got the site structure, URLs, XML sitemaps, and other components which need to provide more information about what each of the pages is all about. And navigation is more than having a menu at the top of a site. It is how you direct users and search engines to the most relevant content on a site. And if search engines and users can't understand content easily, the chances are the site is unlikely to rank on top ranking results, which is no bueno. And the catch is to ensure that search engines and users can easily discover and understand important content.
And images play a critical role in web design, but if the images aren't optimized for search engines, they may work against SEO. Page speed forms a vital part of SEO and will determine whether a website will rank higher on Google or not. And that's why Google came up with Core Web Vitals that help determine where to rank a website on search result pages. And as such, ensure to include file names on images and keep the file sizes as small as possible. This way, search engines will understand images, and those images won't take forever to load. I recommend tinypng.com to optimize your images. It's a free service. I probably use it with most of my sites.
And don't ignore image alt attributes. Ensuring that images load faster is only the beginning. You also need to include alt attributes to be 100% W3C compliant. However, this doesn't involve adding any text to your images. Alt attributes need to be relevant and accurate. And alt attributes help search engines like Google understand images to determine whether they are relevant to a search query. And they're also helpful for users who cannot see images.
And then you'll want to make sure that the content you create is crawlable by search engines. Creating informative and unique content is one thing. Ensuring that users can actually locate content on the web page is a totally different thing. This is where the term crawlable comes in. In other words, can search engine spiders discover and fetch every link within a website? Can it? But web crawling bots are programs used by search engines to locate and revisit content on web pages to determine how many pages of these sites are crawlable. If a bot cannot follow a link, it will not be found in the search results.
Now, I encourage you to think about designing search-friendly URLs. Search-friendly URLs are good for search engine optimization and user experience. And more specifically, well-optimized URLs meet the needs of searchers and users. And URLs are among the most important factors that search engines use to rank a page on search results. In fact, URLs describe a web page to potential visitors and search engines. I mean, just think about it in your own journey today when you're on Google. And as such, they need to be accurate and well-structured to describe your page appropriately.
Next, you'll want to update website content. A website is unlikely to have good SEO if it contains stale content. That's why we recommend updating content on a website from time to time. More so, keeping content fresh will help reduce bounce rate, which can otherwise hurt SEO. Updating a website regularly is critical when it comes to SEO. I mean, for instance, leaving a huge gap between posts will make the website less credible. Besides, checking a website more often will help stay on top of things like broken links. Users and search engines want to see content changing regularly. Content will be more crawlable by search engines and more valuable to users.
As you can see, SEO and web design work hand in hand, just like Neely and myself. And for web designers and developers, it's not something to be ignored, even if your skill set is more specialized in other areas. So gather resources, including this checklist, to brush up on your knowledge and make sure you're covering the key areas for yourself and your clients. All right, that's a wrap, but your journey doesn't have to end here. We have over 300 videos for you to watch.
So be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching. This is The Journey.